Why, when people are witnesses, why aren't they taking more pride in their story of what they're telling? Why do they got to be confined to that little box on the witness stand? I'm going to be like, listen, Your Honor, do you mind if I have the floor? I want to act this out. Do you want to crack this case wide open or not, my man?
All right, y'all. Let's hit those high notes.
Okay, I'll go first because you were really proud of yours. Yours is probably going to be better than mine. But my high note is, this is my advice. I've thought about this long and hard. People always ask if you had to give advice to criminals, how to get away with stuff. So here's my advice. If you're thinking about becoming a mule or a drug courier and using your vehicle, fill your trunk full of tennis balls, because drug dogs love tennis balls. That's their reward. When they do what they're supposed to do and find drugs, they lose their mind because they get the tennis ball. You pop open a trunk full of nothing but tennis balls, the dog's going to have a heart attack. Drop dead on the spot.
He's going to forget what any drug smells like. Like, fuck your drugs. Fuck your non-paycheck ass giving me. Give me them tennis balls, kid. Here's a 1,000 tennis balls.
Endless tennis balls. They just go crazy. They lose their fucking mind. They're useless as a drug dog after a trunk full of tennis balls.
This is a podcast you want to listen to. This is the type of shit you learn, man, from a 22-year police veteran. All right. So here's my high note. A lot of people say that, you know, these crime shows, all this crime TV, it gets us ready to be better criminals, right? Again, though, in some cases, that is true. Some people will become better criminals because they watch all this behind the scenes and how to bob and weave law enforcement. But then there's people out there that never planned on doing crimes, and they don't care how many hot inside crime tips they get to be better criminals. They're never going to be criminals. But I'll tell you this. I am – what crime TV has got me ready for is to be a fucking witness. I am so ready to be a witness. Now, one time, this is a true story. This is what got me thinking about it. I think we actually spoke about this one time. I don't know in what forum. But my lady and myself, we went on a hike, a Lear National Forest or near Lear National Park. And we're on a hike in the daytime. And there's probably a couple up ahead of us. They were ahead of us by maybe 60 yards, 70 yards, you know. But on the way back in the hike, it was just a guy, right? Like, where the fuck did your girl go, bro, on this hike? Like, we ran back into him. Now, at that moment, I clicked right into fucking police crime show TV guy. Like, okay, let's start looking for footprints. What shirt's he wearing? What logo's on the shirt? How tall? Because he kept on doing this number. Like, you know when you think someone's looking at you and you keep fucking turning around? Trying because you're fucking paranoid. He kept on looking back at us, and it got to a point where I was at my lady. I was like, listen, we need to fall back. Yeah. Something's up with this dude. Like, where the fuck's his lady at? We're on a hike. There's a strong chance we're balls deep in a goddamn murder investigation. We'll be called on to be witnesses. We're gonna be called to the stand.
We're walking behind Scott Peterson right now. He just fucking threw his wife off a cliff.
And guess what? I was taking all the notes. I was ready, bro. If he actually did do something and he called me to the stand and I got called to the stand as a witness, I would have been so ready, bro. And here's my other part. Part two of that is, why, when people are witnesses, why aren't they taking more pride in their story of what they're telling? Why do they got to be confined to that little box on the witness stand? I'm going to be like, listen, Your Honor, attorneys, do you mind if I have the floor? I want to act this out. Give me the whole floor. Don't confine me to this box. Do you want to crack this case wide open or not, my man? Can I have the floor? I can see the judge and the attorney like, oh, I guess you can fucking have the floor. You're the witness. You're the star witness.
What if you just take it on your own accord? You walk up there, you sit down in the box, and you grab the mic that's in the little mic stand, just like when you take the stage and take it out of the mic stand, and you just take the mic out and just walk around with it. Start walking all around.
Yeah.
Start engaging the left side of the room, right side of the room.
And then he asks you a question. You go, it's funny you asked that. You grab the mic off, and then you fucking walk out onto the main floor. I was there at Lear Park with my lady. You'll call her to the stand as well. Our suspect, 6'2", roughly about 50 yards out. I have pretty good experience with a young lady, blonde. I'd say about 5'5". at roughly 5:50, the hike started. Like, I would be so fucking detailed. I am so ready to be a witness. And then it just like at that point, I want to go start combing through the whole courtroom, bro. I want to start telling everybody what they're up to, what they're doing wrong. Like, one thing that the world has to understand is that the internet has made us all experts. And that is us. I'm a fucking expert. You're an expert. I'll tell the judge what he's up to, what he's doing wrong. I'll tell the fucking bailiff, the lady doing the typing, the weird guy in the back corner that's probably with the real people who did the murder, and he's just keeping track on it. Like, everybody, dude, the jury, juror seven, what's your deal? I'll fucking check the whole office, the whole operation. I'm from the internet age now, and guess what? We're experts in everything.